glass fire was far from finished this morning as it continued its destructive march through parts of Napa County, much of it along Silverado Trail.
And this whole neighborhood was engulfed. We got out of here about 2:45, and it was like a firestorm. There was fire on both sides of the street. The school here was burning down. The houses here all around were engulfed in flames.
The school is Foothills Adventist Elementary. A main building was completely destroyed. Like so many before it, the wind-whipped glass fire seems random in its destruction, leaving some buildings in ruins, like the Chateau Boswell Winery, while others, like this historic home on Glass Mountain Road, are completely unscathed.
The fire got extremely close.
Abner Castanon considers himself among the lucky. He manages and lives at the Elms Haven home, more than a century old, located in the shadow of Glass Mountain, where the fire started Sunday morning.
I'm feeling that an angel must have been hovering over here, guarding this place, and kept it from burning. I don't know what else to think. When everything else around us burned and this property here survived.
And this is one of those buildings that did not survive. Again, it looks to be a main building of sorts here at the Foothills Adventist Elementary School. This is the Deer Park neighborhood. Technically, it's still a St. Helena address. And I can tell you, unfortunately, there are a number of homes. We counted probably up to about 50 in this neighborhood that have burned. If there's anything good about today so far, it is that it's while it's still relatively hot, close to 100 degrees. As far as we can tell, the winds have died down here almost completely. Dion, Larry.
Here's the bridge to the entrance of Mrs. White's house. You can see it burned. Here's the creek. It's all burned. And over here is the mailboxes. They're all thrown on the floor. The fence is burned. Over here across the street, well, fortunately, Mrs. White's sign is still standing. Isn't that wonderful? And across the street, it's all burned. See? All the way around. Over there, still smoldering in all the smoke. And so here, Elms Haven is surrounded by fire and smoke, but the Lord spared Elms Haven. Isn't that a miracle?
During the months of September to October 2020, a terrible fire burned through the Napa and Sonoma County, California, destroying millions of acres of land and many historic buildings and vineyards. The fire was said to be one of the worst in recorded history in California. Amidst all the destruction, there was one major miracle at St. Helena. The Passover of Sister Ellen G. White property. All the buildings and fields surrounding the property was burnt. But the fire stopped right before the signpost that bore her name. This was such a profound lesson and direct communication from God, saying, quote, "Touch not mine anointed, and do my prophet no harm," unquote. Psalms 105 verse 15. As in the days of biblical Israel, when the destroying angel descended upon Egypt, when he saw the blood which symbolized Christ on their houses, he spared their lives and houses and passed over. Exodus 12, verse 12, 13, and 23. So it was with Sister White's property. The blood of Christ was upon her property, and the destroying angel passed over it. Now, the question is, who exactly was this woman called Ellen G. White that God should be so gracious to her memory to spare her former residence? Sister White, as she is lovingly and fondly called, is one of the founding members, pioneer, and prophetess of the Adventist Church. Born November 26, 1827, and died July 16, 1915, at this same property at Elms Haven, St. Helena, California. Over her lifetime, starting as a teenager, she would receive many dreams, visions, and messages from God, which was documented in many of her books and writings. Among her many writings are counsel to the churches on how to live a perfect Christian life, counsels on mental health, mind, character, and personality. She gave to the church an accurate interpretation of prophecy on the books of Daniel and Revelation. She also wrote a commentary of the whole Bible called Conflict of the Ages, in which she spoke about the beginning of creation to the second coming of Christ. Sister White also emphasized the need for Christian education as being the cornerstone of an upright society. In one of her writings, she said, quote, "The true object of education is to restore the image of God in the soul," unquote, taken from Mind, Character, and Personality, Volume 1, page 359. In another place, she said, quote, "Throughout the world, society is in disorder, and a thorough transformation is needed. The education given to the youth is to mold the whole social fabric," unquote. Mind, Character, and Personality, Volume 1, page 367. Such words are so relevant to this time. Another great contribution that Sister White made that she is not credited for is in the health field. She received the health message directly from God, which became the cornerstone and the foundation of good health for the Adventist people. Today, we have 5 blue zones in the world. Blue zones are areas of longevity where people are the healthiest and oldest upon the earth. Loma Linda, California, is one of the 5 places and the only place in America where people live to be healthy centurions and live 10 years longer than the average American. Who are these people? They are Seventh-day Adventists who follow Sister White's health message of veganism. The health and wellness movement in America has greatly been influenced by Sister White's early work in diet, health, and wellness, without even knowing it. Today, many Adventists have questioned Sister White's relevance in an atheistic and corrupt world, and have assigned her writings to the trash heap of history. How unfortunate. By sparing her former home, God spoke directly to us. God, in such a dramatic fashion, is sending a direct message and answering the question of relevance. Not only is he by this bold move saying she is relevant, but very relevant for this age more than ever. And so I plead with my dear Seventh-day Adventist brethren, my evangelical friends, and the world at large, give her a hearing and at least read one of her books and decide for yourself if this woman is truly a woman of God. I can assure you, in today's COVID world, her health message is more relevant than ever. May God bless you as you contemplate these things and as you make an attempt to at least read one of her books. May God bless you and open your eyes. God bless. Amen.